Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Super Hornet. Super Hornet, not Heartseeker. This test will come later. As you might know, CRG buffed missile and torpedo damage a lot in 3.6, and CRG buffed the all-stop default shields of the Super Hornet a little bit at least. We are starting with one size one missile. Shields front side 71, stern at maximum. And one size 2 missile. Shields front side 59, stern at maximum, and we have a red spot at the cockpit. What's going on? Our shields were still fine. I can't see any cosmetic damage. Wow, we already have a red spot on the HUD, where your shields are in a very sad state. There was a shield rework scheduled for 3.6, but I guess it's postponed. Poor little thing. But we are fine. No problems. Normal SM speed, afterburner. Normal flight controls. At once a 3 missile on the way. Shields one side 53, stern at maximum, and again we have this red spot at the front that doesn't seem to do anything strange. No cosmetic damage. But this is real damage. This spot is weakened. Yeah, we need better shields, Chris. One SAS-4 missile on the way. Shields front side 34, stern at maximum, and again the red spot at the front. And again we cannot see any cosmetic damage, but this is real damage. We have all our guns, normal SCM speed, afterburner, and this looks like normal flight controls. And two SAS-4 missiles. Okay, that's a kill already. Just for your information, an Aurora MR can survive two SAS-4 missiles. So much for balancing. And two SAS-4 missiles one more time to make sure it wasn't just a lucky hit. SAS-5 torpedoes now. One SAS-5 torpedo. Shields down, front side, stern at maximum, the front is red again, and the air intakes are orange. Any cosmetic damage? Nope. We had so much, so nice cosmetic damage before 3.0. Maybe I make a compilation of my 2.6.3 footage. It looked very, very nice. Well, what do we have? We have all our guns. We have normal speed, afterburner, and this looks like normal flight controls. Two SAS-5 torpedoes. And as always, just for fun, one SAS-9 torpedo. I don't want to repeat myself over and over, so I have those two memes and I use missiles and torpedoes just as a yardstick. And we have our third ship tested in 3.6, a Super Hornet. The CLG made changes to size 1 shields in 3.6, some were buffed, others were nerfed. The CLG buffed most size 2 shields, and size 3 shields were not changed by much. And the CLG obviously buffed missile and torpedo damage a lot in 3.6. I always test ships in default loadout. Occasionally I do some component testing. I can tell you one thing, if you want to use the Super Hornet in 3.6, replace her default shield generators as quickly as you can. As you can see, the Super Hornet is much more fragile than an Aurora MR now. Super Hornet killed by 2 size 4 missiles, Aurora MR not. And Aurora MR takes much less shield damage when hit by size 1, size 2 and size 3 missiles. This was very different in the past. In 2.6.3, Aurora MR was very weak and Super Hornet was very, very tough. Here you are. And this continued in 3.2, 3.3, 3.4 and 3.5, where Super Hornet was a lot tougher than an Aurora MR. Well, the Super Hornet is supposed to be a tough brawler, and I guess CHA has to make a lot more balance changes in the future of this game. Aurora MR tougher than Super Hornet does make zero sense. And yes, I talk about default loadout, so change this as quickly as you can. Let's take a look at the comparison of data of the Super Hornet from 2.6.3 to today. And between 3.5 and 3.6, her default shields, which are all stops, were buffed again. She has now 1.36 times as many shield HPs. However, missile and torpedo damage was buffed as well. Size 1 missiles in 3.5 92%, now 71%. Size 2 missiles 85%, now 59%, and the front is already red. Yeah, shields are in a very sad state, and a lot of ships have shields with holes, and parts of some ships are not even covered by the shields. We need a shield rework very soon. Some people hoped we would get it in 3.6, but no, we didn't. Size 3 missiles 75 and now 53. Red spot in both cases at the front. Size 4 missiles in 3.5 killed by 3 size 4 missiles, now killed by 2. Size 5 torpedoes in 3.5, shields at 31%, front side stern max, front red, and now shields are down. Front side, stern max and front is red, and 2 size 5 torpedoes are still a kill, and 1 size 9 torpedo is and always was a kill, and most likely always will be. Would I go into battle in a Super Hornet in 3.6? Yes, but only if I would replace the shield, so the full shield generators as quickly as possible, because this doesn't make sense. Obviously, many mechanics are still missing, for example, real armor, and this bothers me because armor doesn't have to be physicalized. CHG, you just have to use some non-generic numbers. How hard can this be? Give us armor soon, please. However, the Super Hornet is not the tough brawler she is supposed to be, and she is not the tough brawler she was before 3.0. I guess she will be again one fine day. So my rating for the Super Hornet is 5 out of 10, which is not a bad rating. This is average, and right now I think the Super Hornet is average at best. Yeah, one fine day she will be your tough brawler again, I hope. I'm sure. I'm pretty much sure. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet and to my Locus wonderful data sheets in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video, and see you next time. Bye! I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors, and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now, all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.